Hey, what up? It's Will Maker. Today I'm going to go over my favorite sampler, which is Serato Sampler, and I'm going to go over the features that I like in it. So once your sample's loaded, in this area right here, this is going to be the original key of the sample, and this is going to be the tempo of the sample. Over in this area, this is going to be if you wanted to change the tempo of the sample, which it should automatically be synced. And then if you want to use double time, this is what you would check. And if you want to use half time, you can go ahead and check right here. This is going to eject your sample if you need to. So this is your pad playback. So if this is checked, you have to hold down the pad in order for the sample to keep playing. Otherwise, you can just hit this, hit it once, and it'll play it out for you. You can also favorite pads as well. Down here is going to be where you set your slicer. So this will randomly do it. This allows you to set it up either by bars or you can set it up by measures on the grid. And this setting allows the algorithm to find the samples here for you. Now, for those that don't know, if you hit the mono button, it's going to hit your sample one note at a time. Poly's going to do more than one note at a time. Now, to copy a setting over, what you do is you hold down the Option key and you just drag it to an empty pad. You can use this for manipulation. So, for instance, if I want to filter out this pad right here, I can go ahead and filter it out. And now it's going to sound different than what is down here. So that makes it really easy to go ahead and manipulate something differently that you want in the same place and keep the same settings and whatnot. So you got your time stretch area right here. So if you have a sample that's not fitting and you just need to move it just a little bit, this is where you would do that. And this also has double time and half time as well. If you have a one shot and you want to go ahead and play that out, you can go ahead and hit the keypad once you load in your sample. Now, if you want to make a chop, here's where you're going to zoom in and you can zoom out. If you're playing your sample, you'll notice that the sample moves around. If you want that to stay in place so that way you can just take a look at the sample, what you would do is that you could hit the freeze button. And then here's your reverse. And then all of your pads are all independent as well. So you can put different effects and whatnot on all of these different pads. And those are definitely the main features that I like off Serato Sample. And this is by far my favorite sampler. So if you have any other questions, feel free to drop a comment. And if you like what you see, please feel free to like and subscribe. Other than that, peace out.